वेलकम टू डीसीबी सूर्यापेटा यूट्यूब चैनल खम्मम एंड सूर्यापेटा डिस्ट्रिक्ट नाइन्थ क्लास ऑनलाइन क्लास सोशल स्टडीज। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच ए लेसन फ्रॉम नाइन्थ क्लास सोशल स्टडीज सेकंड पेपर 14th लेसन सोशल प्रोटेस्ट मूवमेंट्स। इन दिस लेसन आई एम गोइंग टू कवर इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन एंड कॉन्सिक्वेंसेस अर्ली वर्कर्स मूवमेंट्स इन इंग्लैंड लुद्दिज्म। सो दीज आर द थ्री टॉपिक्स टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू कवर। सो दिस इज वड्डे चंद्रशेखर working as a school assistant social studies at GHS CPS Madura in Khammam district. So these are the learning outcomes of today's class. The students explains about consequences of industrialization. So what is the impact of industrialization on the society? The student explains about early workers movements in England. The student explains about Karma laws. The student explains about the main principles of Luddism. So these are the learning outcomes of today's class. So by students, listen carefully. By listening today's class, you can achieve these learning outcomes. Industrialization and emergence of nation states. So first, we should learn what is industrialization. So industrialization means establishment of industries and production of goods through industries in larger scale. That is nothing but industrialization. It was started in England firstly than any other country. England is located in Europe. So we can say industrialization started in Europe. So because of this industrialization, it shows impact on lives of people in so many ways, like it changed lives of people. Industrialization changed the way of work. So before industrialization, the working nature is different, and at the time of industrialization, the working nature is different. It changed the way of work also. At the same time, it access to the necessities of life and dignity also changed because of industrialization. So many people, they lost their dignity because of industrialization, like poor workers. Next, relationship with their work and its products, families and neighborhood also changed because of industrialization. So at the when the workers working in industries, they didn't have relation with the products, what they are producing and how they are producing and where they are producing. So the workers, they didn't have any relation with these fundamental questions, and just they have to work under foreman or supervisors, and the relationship with the families also changed, and the relationship with the neighbors also changed at the time of industrialization. So at the same time, it ends the dignified life of people, and it ends the secure life for poor peasants, craft persons and workers. So the poor peasants, they lost their agriculture lands, and the craft persons and workers, they lost their jobs, so they became unemployed in the society. So it's end up the dignified life and secure life. So industrialization gives impact on for work. So the workers forced to work because the industrialists always they want to get more profits. So for that they wanted to workers to work more hours for less salaries, so it becomes a force to work. And the workers and poor people, poor peasants, they have full of dissatisfaction and unhappiness about their work and their wages. So the industrialists, always they are thinking about the profits, and they want to give less salaries to the workers, and they want to get more work from the workers. So it leads to the dissatisfaction and unhappiness of the workers and poor peasants. So in the picture you can observe the large industry. So like these, so many industries were set up in England. So the people, they have to work in these industries for their livelihood. So using these industries, in these industries using a large scale machines, so the production has done with rapid speed. So in the early decades of industrialization, new political ideas like liberty, equality, fraternity, they emerged. So on these political ideas, impact of French Revolution is there, because in the time of French Revolution only these new political ideas emerged in the society, and all the people who suffered because of industrialization, they want to get these three political ideas, and they started learning about these liberty, equality and fraternity. So when they came to know about these political ideas, they started mass actions like protests against the cruel factory owners and working conditions. So based on these political ideas, French parliamentary assemblies also created in 1970s. So industrialization gives deeply troubled artists and intellectuals. So it didn't give any importance to the artists and intellectuals. And based on the protests, they wanted to control the prices of necessities like bread. So if the prices of bread increased in in larger scale, it affects the lives of the poor people. And industrialization lost the human values. Always all the people, they are thinking about the work and wages, and factory owners also gives importance to the profits and gives importance to the only money, but they didn't follow any human values. So because of the industrialization, human values were lost in the society. At the same time, the people, they started focus on reason, science and technology rather than feelings and emotions of the people. So when they started giving importance to the reason, science and technology, they started thinking reasonably and logically than emotionally, and they gave importance to the technology rather than the feelings of human beings. Feelings are different and science is different. Sometimes feelings are different from the scientific logic. Okay, so that's why in the society, the people started thinking regionally and gives importance to the science and technology. So children, you can observe the picture. In this picture, the people are the workers, they are protesting against the cruel rulers and factory owners. So how they are trying to suppress the workers and the protesters by using weapons also. So this is a cruel practice against the poor workers. Some of the people in the society, they started studying economics and social history. So the people, why they started studying economics? So economics is useful for understanding of impact of industrialization and industrial loss. And the people also started studying the social history of the people, how the social changes occurred from so many years. Some of them studied poetry and art for inspiration for alternative virtues. So some of the people, they started studying poetry to inspire the people by using their poems and their writings. And some of the people, they started studying art. So by using art, they can inspire the people and workers against the cruel practices. So birth to new social groups like capitalists and large landowners and working class. So because of the industrialization in the society, so some new social groups were emerged like capitalists, landowners and working class. So workers realized about their strength and also inspired by French Revolution and socialism. So when they heard about French Revolution and when they realized about the new political ideas like liberty, equality, fraternity, they realized about their strength. If we unite all, we can achieve our rights. So the workers started, became unite, and they started forming trade unions, like, and they want to follow the principles of socialism and French Revolution also. At the same time, women also demanded for equal status, and they wanted to participate in the society and economic activities and political activities and cultural activities. So women demanded for equal status, equal participation in all activities related to society, economy, polity and culture. So it shows the importance of women and the realization of women in the society. Children, so this picture is there in your textbook also. So in this picture we can observe the quarters of poor workers in London. It is a painting by Dore in 1876. So we can understand the conditions of poor workers. Living conditions are very bad at the time of industrialization. The industrial owners, they didn't provide any basic amenities to the poor workers. Just always they wanted to get more profits by using cruel practices, and they didn't provide minimum facilities like pure drinking water, health facilities, education facilities and sanitation and facilities. So we can understand the conditions of workers by seeing this picture. So early workers movements in England. So in England, at the time of industrialization and industrial time, the workers, they started movements in England against the cruel practices which were practiced by the factory owners. The workers protested against the cruel working conditions. So firstly, the factory workers, they want to change the working conditions of workers. So at the early time of industrialization, the workers had to work more hours, more than 12 hours, 13 hours, up to 18 hours also they have to work. So it's very cruel. So they, at the same time, in the places of working in industries, the owners, they didn't provide a basic pure drinking water and health facilities and education facilities. So there were no restrooms, and there were no lunch time. They have to work and they have to take their lunch at the meal time. So these are the cruel working conditions. The people or workers, they started fighting with each other. So demanding for the right to vote. So the people, they demanded for right to vote. When they thought that when we have right to vote, we can elect our leaders, and through our leaders we can achieve our rights or goals. But the government made new laws to repress the protesters. The government didn't give any chance to form new trade unions like trade unions, and at the same time government trying to repress the protesters forcefully by using police action. England had war with France for a long time. So England had war with France for a long time, from 1792 to 1815. Because of this long war, trade between England and Europe disrupted. So the trade disturbed between England and other European countries because of long war. And at the same time, factories were forced to shut down. So many factories and factory owners, they shut down their factories. So because of this shutdown, so many workers who are working in factories, they lost their job, they become unemployed in the society. So unemployment rate is increased. So when the factories were forced to shut down, it gives chance to rise in prices of all essential goods like food, bread, meat. So the prices of all essential goods increased. So wages not increased, but the wages of the people didn't increase. But the prices of essential goods increased. So here the wars created more problems. One is a forced shutdown of factories and created more unemployment. So unemployment leads to the lack of money in the hands of the workers. So they didn't afford for their livelihood also. So rise in prices also affects the life of the unemployed. So at the same time, the work increased, but the work wages are not increased to the workers. In 1795, Parliament passed two combination acts to suppress the people or workers. So based on the combination acts, it made it illegal to incite the people by speech or writing to hatred or contempt of king, constitution or government. So in 1975, Parliament passed two combination acts. So the rules are the based on these combination acts, the people cannot speak against the king or constitution or government, and they cannot write any writings which are against the king, constitution and government. So it shows that the government's forcefully trying to suppress the voice of the people, and the right to expression also they want to suppress. At the same time, because of this act or laws, they banned unauthorized public meetings of more than 50 persons. So these combination acts banned unauthorized public meetings of more than 50 persons. So why the government banned on these public meetings? It means if the people unite or meet in one place, they discuss about their working conditions like that. So when they discuss about their conditions, they may protest against the factory owners or government. So that's why the government made, particularly they made acts, and they trying to suppress people and the strength. Even then, the government introduces so many acts and combination acts, the protests against the old corruption continued in the society or England. What do the children, do you know what is old corruption? Guess. So old corruption, the term old corruption was used for the privileges that the monarchy and parliament had. So in the society, the monarchy means the king and the family and the relatives and the parliament. So both have more privileges, but the common people, the workers, they didn't have any privileges which the parliament have. So this is nothing but old corruption. The people protested against this old corruption. They wanted to remove the privileges to the monarchy and parliament, and at the same time the people, they wanted more fundamental rights to the poor sections and workers. So at the same time, members of the parliament, so who are the members of the parliament? Landowners, manufacturers and professionals, these are the members of parliament. They are not ready to give right to vote to the working population, and they are not ready to lose their privileges which have given by parliament. But the workers or working class, they want more rights, and they wanted to remove the privileges of monarchy and parliament. So here is a contradictory between the views of workers and parliament. They supported the corn laws. Children, do you know what are corn laws? Corn laws. Listen carefully. So these laws made to prevent the import of cheaper food until prices in Britain had risen to a certain level. So the people cannot import cheaper food until the prices in Britain had risen to a certain level. So corn laws prevent the imports of cheaper food, which helpful to the poor people. The workers came together in towns and factories and protested in anger and frustration. So the workers who lost their jobs and the workers who are working in cruel work conditions, all the people who are getting low wages for more work, they all came together in towns and factories and protested in anger and frustration. They showed their anger and they showed their frustration. So against the factory owners and against the poor working conditions and these corn laws like this. Bread or food rights throughout the country from the 1790s onwards. So the people who lost their job, they suffered with the lack of money and they need bread for their livelihood. But there is no chance to get bread and food because they didn't have any employment and they didn't have money. That's why the workers who lost their job and the poor people, they started rights for bread and food throughout the country from 1790s onwards. So it shows the frustration of the people, poor people in the England. So one of the another important practice which was caused for more problems to the poor people, that is enclosure. In 1770, small farms had been merged into the large ones under powerful landlords. So here enclosure. Before industrialization, the landlords, they gave their lands to the poor peasants for rental purpose. But in 1970s, the landowners, they thrown out the small peasants or poor peasants from their land and they started merge all the small farms into larger farms and they fenced their lands in larger scale. So when they started enclosures by fencing their lands, small farmers they lost their lands and they became unemployed. So at the same time, machines which were introduced in the factories, they brought into cotton industries, weavers lost their job. At the same time, weavers, they thought that because of these machines we lost our jobs, so we have to destroy them. Weavers demanded for minimum wages, but Parliament refused to give minimum wages also to the weavers. At the same time, factory owners, they introduced machines. So machines replaced so many number of workers replaced by one machine. So because of the introducing of machines in the factories, so many hundreds of workers, they lost their job and they became unemployment and they suffered for food. So workers or weavers, they demanded for minimum wages and they refused by Parliament. Workers went on strikes. At the same time, workers destroyed power looms. They thought that these looms occupied their place. In Akshire, croppers destroyed shearing frames. Farm laborers destroyed threshing machines. So in each and every field, machines were introduced and workers lost their job. So the workers who are working in different factories who lost their job because of machines, they started destroying the machines in their field, like threshing machines in agriculture field, power looms in weaving sections by weavers. Yorkshire, croppers means who cut the fur from the sheep, so they destroyed shearing machines. Like this, the workers, they protested against the introducing of machines because machines are causing for the loss of jobs. So in the England, another ideology was started, that is Luddism. The name of Luddism derived from the name of a person who led this movement, General Ned Ludd. So he is a charismatic person. He has some ideas about the present societal conditions. So the Luddism demanded for a minimum wage to the all workers. So this is a basic demand of Luddism. So at the same time, they wanted to control over the labor of women and children. So in the factories, in the early industrialization time, so the factory owners give more work to the women and children. They wanted to control over the labor of women and children, and they demanded for less work for women and children. So at the same time, they demanded work for jobless workers who lost their job by machines. So because of introducing of machines, so many hundreds of workers, they lost their job. They became unemployment in the society, and they are suffering for food and at minimum bread also. So Luddism mainly demanded for work for jobless workers. At the same time, they asked for the right to form trade unions. So they wanted to form trade unions. So the workers, they thought that are the people, the followers of Luddism, they also want to form trade unions. Because of trade unions, they thought that they can achieve their rights and they can fulfill their basic needs also. So that's why they demanded for the right to form trade unions. They fought by threatening to damage the machines and stock of the owners. So they fought by threatening to damage the machines and stocks of the owners. So the workers, they threaten the factory owners, we will damage machines and stocks of owners. So then the owners, here we can observe the picture, the followers of this, they are destroying machines. So they thought that machines, because of machines only they lost their jobs, that's why they are destroying the machine. Finally, the owners agreed to negotiate with workers. Finally, the owners, factory owners, they agreed to negotiate with the workers. The workers and many middle class persons like shopkeepers and master craftsmen thought that machines were unnecessary. So the people who are living in society and towns, the poor people or shopkeepers or master craftsmen, they thought that machines were unnecessary, and because of the machines only we are losing our jobs, that's why we don't want any machines. They felt that machines were being introduced to take away their livelihood. So they thought that the factory owners introduced the machines to remove the workers from factories and to get more profits. In many places, the radical workers worked spontaneously in the name of General Ludd. So in many places, the radical workers worked spontaneously in the name of General Ludd to achieve their demands. So what are the main demands of Luddism? So minimum wage, demanded for minimum wage, and they wanted to reduce the labor of women and children, and they wanted job for jobless workers who lost by machines, and they asked for the right to form trade unions. At the same time, they fought by threatening to damage the machines and stocks of the owners. Finally, the factory owners agreed to negotiate. This is about the Luddism. So up to now, we have discussed three topics, three important topics. One is the industrialization and consequences of industrialization, and workers movements in early industrialization in England. Next, third topic is Luddism and principles of Luddism. So now I will try to recapitulate the lesson with important principles or important points. So the industrialization changed the lives of the people in so many ways. The way of work is changed, the relations between the people are changed, the work nature changed. So the workers, they forced to work. At the same time, the relationship with the factory, product and worker, they didn't have any relationship. So like this, the industrialization shows impact on the lives of the people. The new ideas of French Revolution are liberty, equality and fraternity. So these are the basic ideas of French Revolution. Based on these basic ideas, the people who are living in England, they also inspired and they wanted all to get these in their country also. So based on these basic ideas, they also inspired and they started protest to get these ideas. Industrialization deeply troubled artists and intellectuals. So because of the industrialization, it troubled the artists and intellectuals also. So the old corruption was used for the privileges that the monarchy and the parliament had. So old corruption, children, already we have discussed what is old corruption. The term old corruption was used for the privileges that the monarchy and the parliament had. It means the monarchic king. Monarchy means the king and the family of the kings and the nobles and parliament. The people of members of the parliament, they have some special privileges which the poor people doesn't have. So next, enclosure caused problems for the people. So because of the enclosures, the poor peasants, they lost their work in farmlands, and the land owners, they started fence their lands by merging small lands into larger ones. So that caused for the problems to the poor people. So Luddism, led by General Ned Ludd, he demanded for minimum wages, and he demanded for work for jobless workers, and he demanded to reduce the work of women and children. So like this, we can understand the lesson, children. So up to now, we have discussed about the first part in social protest movements. So now I am giving some questions for evaluation purpose. Children, try to answer these questions. Try to write answers these questions and show to your social studies teachers. Write about the changes which are there in industrialization. Define old corruption. What are the reasons for workers' movement in England? What are the problems created by enclosure? Explain about the main principles of Luddism. So try to write answers to these all questions in a separate notebook for your social studies notebook, and show to your teacher and make it correct. Okay, thank you children. We will meet in second part 2 of social protest movements. Thank you, one and all.